In this video, we're going to be discussing stream updates. Stream updates is a similar concept to WebSockets, in that it allows you to retrieve only new values from attributes and points as events are added and the streams are updated. Stream updates relies on HTTP requests to send new values only when queried, and only provides values since the last time the stream was queried. This prevents you from having to pull more info than is needed, and you won't need to maintain a number of WebSocket connections to the PyWeb API. Let's see what this looks like in action. For stream updates, we register a particular stream to receive updates from. This is done by using the stream controller / the web ID of the stream followed by / updates. I've already selected the dummy tag CDT158 web ID for this example. Let's execute this request. The response of the initial request is a status of whether or not updates were able to be subscribed to on that stream. We see a 200 HTTP status, which is good. We also see a field in the response called status, which says the registration succeeded as well. If you or another user have already signed up for stream updates on this particular stream, then the status will be already registered. So let's make this request a second time, just so we can see what this looks like. We still have a 200 HTTP response code, but as we mentioned, the status in the response body has changed to already registered. Let's take a look at some of the other components of the response we get when we're registering. We have a latest marker property being returned to us. This marker keeps track of the last time we queried the stream for updates. We can hand this marker to the PyWeb API when asking for updates, and it will know where in the stream was the last time we got updates. Let's use that marker to retrieve some updates. The URL for this will be formatted as the base URL /streams/updates/ the marker that was retrieved from the message in which we registered for updates. We'll also need to change this from a post to a GET request. In this response, we see there's been no events that have been added, and as a result, we see a status of no changed. We also see we have a latest marker property. This marker is different from the one we used to make the request. We can compare this to the marker it's used, as it's shown later in the request as well. For this request, I've ensured we've waited a little bit of time so that the stream has had time to update. In the response, we see an events object with the typical event information, value, timestamp, questionable, substituted, as well as what type of change was made. In this case, all of the events were added, though we could have edited and deleted as possible actions if the changes were made to values in this stream. If we scroll down, we also see we have a latest marker property. This marker is different from the one we used to make the request. We can compare it to the requesting marker, or requested marker, also shown in the response. This new marker can be used to retrieve information from the most recent query for updates moving forward. In other words, if we use the latest marker to query the stream, we won't see updates from this response, but rather updates that have occurred since this response. Let's demonstrate this. We see that the timestamps are more recent than the previous query using the other marker. One more detail I'd like to point out is that markers that have existed for more than 5 minutes will expire and have their events cleaned up. For this example, I've registered for stream updates, and used a marker that should now be expired. When we hit execute, we see we have a 404 response. Because the marker is expired, we no longer find data for that stream update.
We covered a lot of material in this video, so let's summarize. I'd first like to go over some of the benefits Stream Updates has to offer over channels. Stream Updates has the benefit in that it's fully based on the HTTP protocol, which means it's compliant with claims-based authentication, whereas channels are not. Additionally, WebSockets aren't consistently supported in all production environments. The Stream Updates model also allows for the client to request updates when it's ready, rather than requiring a consistent pull to the channel or implementing a callback. Last but certainly not least, stream updates have more desirable behavior in the event of a network interruption between the client and the PyWeb API. In stream updates, a network interruption may cause an individual HTTP GET request to fail, but the server will not lose updates or signup context. This means that when subsequent HTTP GET calls are made successfully, no data updates are lost. If a channel fails, the client needs to re-establish the connection and resend all web IDs that need to be signed up. Data updates for those streams may be lost while this is occurring.
In this video, we registered for stream updates using a post to the updates endpoint on the stream's controller. We demonstrated the use of markers for retrieving new updates, and we noted the timeout period on markers is a default of 5 minutes. If you find that the cache timeout is too short, we would recommend using a get recorded call with start and end times